In 2016, the Hitchcock Center for the Environment moved into its new living building on West Street in Amherst. Staying true to its mission, this new building was constructed to achieve the most rigorous green building certification in the world. It's also allowed the center to expand its programs and to use the building itself as a teaching tool to support sustainable engineering and greater awareness of our environment. Producer Dave Fraser visited the center recently and shares this story.
This building generates all its power on site. It creates enough potable water for those who visit and work inside it. It is built with responsibly sourced, non-toxic materials. This building became the 23rd building in the world to earn a Certified Living Building Award from the International Living Future Institute, an award that is considered to have some of the most rigorous standards for green buildings.
We just received the award in May, and it's been something that we've been celebrating ever since. It's been a lot of hard work.
The building is the Hitchcock Center for the Environment in Amherst and is used as an innovative teaching tool to educate the next generation of environmental decision makers.
I consider environmental education and environmental literacy one of the critical needs of our time. So this is how people can really get engaged.
Here, yeah, come on over here.
For children, getting them engaged can be as simple as a hike in the woods, like this one led by Hitchcock's environmental educator, Amelia Thompson. The goal with these nature play after-school programs is to give kids an unstructured but naturalist-supported space to play and explore, as well as give them a place to exercise, move their bodies, and just let them be kids. On a more technical side, inside the center, visitors can view a digital dashboard that provides real-time data on how the building is performing.
You can use that dashboard to sort of see on a daily basis or an hourly basis or a monthly basis how much energy the building's using and trends throughout the seasons. We also show how much water is being collected, so it'll show how much rain has fallen in a day, how much we collect, and then also how much we use. This building, for example, uses right now an average of 35 gallons of water per day, which is phenomenal for a 9,000 square foot commercial building. It's occupied quite heavily.
To put that in perspective, an average household uses about 110 gallons of water per day. Outside the building, the land has all native species of plants that promote pollinators and greater biodiversity.
We developed 3 acres here, and so part of the Living Building Challenge is also to say that for every acre that you develop, you have to put another acre into a permanent conservation restriction, so it balances, you know, built environment to protected natural land. I love that about the Living Building Challenge. That's where I think they really kind of surpass in defining what is truly a sustainable way of developing.
The Hitchcock Center was founded in 1962 and moved into its new building in 2016. The Hitchcock name recognizes 3 connections to the environment: Edward Hitchcock, a noted American geologist and the 3rd president of Amherst College; his wife, Aura White Hitchcock, one of America's earliest botanical and scientific illustrators; and Glacial Lake Hitchcock, which began forming 18,000 years ago and at one point stretched from upper Vermont to southern Connecticut. Johnson says the new Hitchcock building has been a draw, increasing attendance significantly.
This year we've seen about 13,000 people, which is, since we've been here, that's about I think 37% increase to what we used to see on an annual basis.
Johnson sees the building as a hopeful place and critical to confronting climate change, environmental toxins, habitat loss, and species extinction.
I think people are really surprised by the way the building works, and then also like how much this building is being used as a teaching tool. So we incorporate it into everything we do with our preschoolers, with our after-schoolers, and the message that we impart is that you can make a difference. I don't think we're expecting everybody to go out and build a living building. This is a pioneering thing, right? And it has all these different elements. So there is something to take away at every level, including just getting kids outside and getting connected to the natural world.